Al-Aslu al-Rabi'u, the fourth foundation of Imam al-Hakim al-Tirmidhi in his precious foundations, Nawadir al-Usul, concerning the sayings and reports of the Holy Messenger Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The fourth foundation entitled Fil Ibtida'i bil Yameen, concerning starting actions with the right. يعني the right side, the right hand. قال حدثنا محمد بن موسى الحرشي وقال حدثنا فضيل بن سليمان قال حدثنا موسى بن عقبة عن أبي حازم عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه أنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا انتعل أحدكم فليبدأ باليمين. Whenever any of you shod themselves, meaning shoe themselves, wear a shoe or a sandal or any footwear, let them begin with the right. وَإِذَا نَزَعَ فَلْيَبْدَأْ بِالشِّمَالِ, and whenever taking it off, let them begin with the left. وَلْيَكُنِ الْيَمِينُ أَوَّلَهُمَا يُلْبَسْ وَآخِرَهُمَا يُنْزَعْ, and let the right side be the first one to be dressed and the last one to be removed. قال حدثنا قتيبة عن مالك بن أنس. So another hadith through Imam Malik with a prestigious chain to Abu Huraira رضي الله عنه عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بمثله سواء, exactly in the same wording. قال أبو عبد الله. Now Imam Hakim al-Tirmidhi comments. فاليمين محبوب الله ومختاره من الأشياء. So the right side, the right direction, the right hand, the right half is Allah's loved one. It is Allah's beloved. And Allah's choice among us. فأهل الجنة عن يمين العرش يوم القيامة. So now he mentions a series of foundations from Quran and Sunnah, such as the people of paradise are to the right of the throne on the day of resurrection. Meaning when they are all before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for judgment, for the reckoning, for the hisab, the people of paradise are on the right, are to the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَهْلُ السَّعَادَةِ يُعْطَوْنَ كُتُبَهُمْ بِأَيْمَانِهِمْ, and the people of felicity and bliss, سَعَادَة. So سَعَادَة is the same as happiness, except it is reserved usually for the hereafter, for paradise. So سَعَادَة, we can translate it as felicity or bliss. And the one that is enjoying that or benefiting from that is called the Sa'id, the happy one.
Sa'id.
So Sa'id being, of course, a normal, well-known first name for men and women, Sa'ida and Sa'id, or Su'ad. You can call it Su'ad also for women, meaning happiness. يُعْطَوْنَ كُتُبَهُمْ بِأَيْمَانِهِمْ, they will be given their records. So we translate the kitab here as the record, because that's what it means in the famous hadith of the records being given. So if one receives it or takes it with the right hand, it means it means he is one of the su'ada. وَكِفَّةُ الْحَسَنَاتِ مِنَ الْمِيزَانِ عَلِ الْيَمِينِ, and the plate of the balance. So now you must imagine an old style balance with two plates, you see, two pendants or two parts. And so the one on the right is the one that supports or weighs the good deeds. So again, the good deeds are on the right side of the balance of deeds on the day of resurrection. And finally, وَالْكِرَامُ الْكَاتِبُونَ, and the honorable record keepers, the honorable scribes, فكاتب الحسنات منهم عن اليمين, the scribe of the good deeds between the two of them is on the right side. I want to mention that when we say the best is the right, and in everything that we are going to read also, it is as he said, a decision from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to honor that meaning. It is a meaning that Allah honors, especially, that gives, it gives it a special meaning. And that doesn't mean that people who are born and raised using the left to write, for example, who are left-handed, as we say, there are millions of them. So that doesn't mean that they are doing the wrong thing by writing with the left. No. But in things that they can control, in things that are easy for them, then they can make at least the intention, you see, and try to follow up with that intention to use the right in order to be subsumed under that symbolic honor and blessing that Allah placed in the right. Because as we say in language, for things that are the opposite of incorrect, the correct is the right. So it is in that sense, but it doesn't mean that that it is not blessed. So it's like Yamin, Yemen, and Shimal, north, as opposed to south, Yemen. North is also the term for unlucky. So Shu'm and Sha'm, and from that we have the term Sham. Sham meaning Syria, Syro-Palestine, north of Medina. But that doesn't mean that it is not blessed. On the contrary, it's the land of prophets and awliya, and there are more than 40 hadiths, you know, praising Sham, recommending Sham. Although Sham and Sha'm literally means misfortune. This is the symbolic side of language. And when it comes to right side, right hand, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose to valorize use of the right. To remind us, you see, it is a reminder that everything in life is a choice. It is an illustration of our free will, really. Everything in life is a choice, and the use of your free will determines whether you are making the right choice and therefore worthy, worthier, taking your good step towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and reward, or else, you know, following the other way. So, هَدَيْنَاهُ السَّبِيلِ or هَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ النَّجْدَيْنِ, the two paths, right or left. So the right symbolizes truth and goodness, and the left symbolizes other than that. But that's not to say that it is wrong to write with the left hand if that is how you have been raised or trained yourself. That's perfectly fine. Just the meaning of it and the intention of it, in whatever you can control, then you choose in those small gestures that we're going to see illustrated in the several hadiths following. For example, he says, قال وكان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يتوخى في كل فعل من مثل هذا اليمين. So the Holy Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم took special care, يتوخى, to choose or start with the rights in every such act that we are going to mention. توخيا لمختار الله, because he wanted to take special care, just as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose that, that as his choice, the right side, you see? وَكَانَ إِذَا شَرِبَ أَعْطَى الْأَيْمَنَ فَالْأَيْمَنَ جُرْعَتَهُ. So whenever he drank, he would give the person to the right, and then the next person to the right, their share of that drink. So جُرْعَ literally means the drought, It's it's a better word than gulp, but it's basically the same thing, right? And it's definitely more than a sip. So it's you know, to your fill of drinking, يعني, more than a sip. حتى إنه شرب يوما وأبو بكر رضي الله تعالى عنه عن يساره. So one day he was drinking and Abu Bakr was to his left. Abu Bakr was sitting to the left of the Holy Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وغلام أعرابي عن يمينه. And a pure Arab child, boy, was to the right of the Holy Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So you see, now we are talking actually about two of the Quraysh. The Mashyakha of Quraysh, that is Abu Bakr, and then the youngster of Quraysh, who is that? That is Mubham in this hadith, Mubham, anonymous. But you know, there is a whole branch of hadith science finding out who is this person, what was that place, on what date this place, and so forth. Whatever they can find out, you see, they will find out. And they found out that this was Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas, the much younger cousin of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because Abbas, his father, was the brother of Sayyidina Abdullah, the father, father of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Right? So, فَقَالَ لِلْغُلَامِ. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to that boy, أَتَأْذَنُ لِي فَأُعْطِيَ الْأَشْيَاخِ. Do you give me permission so that I will give the next turn to the older ones, to the seniors, فقال, because the literal meaning of Shaykh is older person, is right? فقال ما كنت لأوثر بفضلك على نفسي أحدا. Look at the pure Arab speech and manners. I would never prefer, when it comes to your bounty, anyone over me. فَأَعْطَاهُ So the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam gave it to the boy. So lucky companion Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas also, and a son of his father, and of course a cousin of his of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And this is in Bukhari and Muslim. قال وكان يبدأ باليمنى إذا دخل المسجد. He said, the Holy Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم would begin with the right whenever he entered the mosque. ثم إذا خرج أو نزع نعله بدأ باليسرى. Then, whenever he came out of the mosque, or whenever he took off his sandal, he would begin with the left. Aha. كي تكون اليمنى آخر العهد بمسجد مسجد الله لها. So that the right would benefit for being the last one or the last one to be to have been in the mosque. You see, it would be a special honor for the right. You see. فإذا انتعل أو دخل المسجد فالحق لليمين. So whenever shodding himself, shoeing himself, or entering the mosque, then the right is more deserving, you see, to be the first one. So فأقام له حقه. So he would give it that due right of it. See, the due right of the right foot to be the first one in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the last one to leave it. لِأَنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى اخْتَارَهُ وَفَضَّلَهُ. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the right side that particular merit, you see, and chose to give it that merit. ثُمَّ إِذَا خَرَجَ أَوْ نَزَعَ نَعْلَهُ بَقِيَ ذَلِكَ الْحَقُّ لَهُ. And also when leaving the mosque or removing the shoe, then that right still belongs, you see, to the right side. Therefore, فَجَعَلَهُ فِي آخِرِ الْأُمُورِ. So therefore, it you give it that right and you allot it that right and you make sure that it has that right to the last moment, to the last possible moment. You see, this is all an exercise of niyyah. And an exercise of ibadah, even in such a small matter, you see. كي يبقى له ذلك الخير أكثر مما كان لليسار. So that that goodness will remain for the right side more than it remained for the left. See. ليكون فضله على اليسار في كل وقت قائمة. So that the superiority of the right, that symbolic superiority, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala endowed it with merit, that superiority remains to the right always, to the right side always. That is like a rule that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided. In every moment, في وقت ابتداء الخير, the moment of the beginning of goodness, والانصراف عن الخير, and leaving the goodness, we're talking here about the entering the house of Allah, leaving the house of Allah, you see, وَقَطْعِهِ, and stopping that, because now you are in a lesser place. That is why you step into the world and out of the house of Allah with the left foot. لِأَنَّهُ إِذَا دَخَلَ الْمَسْجِدَ فَهُوَ فِي رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ وَخَيْرِهِ, because entering the mosque, you enter the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the goodness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who himself is the absolute good. تَقَدَّمَ الْيُمْنَى إِلَى تِلْكَ الرَّحْمَةِ. So you give priority to the right for that mercy, towards that mercy. You see, your right side is, and this is what it means when you say you enter on the good foot. The Americans have this expression, you know, the good foot, meaning the right side, and putting, you know, right side forward. وَإِذَا خَرَجَ أَخَّرَهَا, and when leaving that, then you leave the right side last, you see, so that it enjoys that goodness to the last. لِيَكُونَ بَقَاؤُهَا فِي الرَّحْمَةِ أَكْثَرَ, so that its lingering and residing in mercy is longer, even for a small measure of time. وَقَدَّمَ الْيُسْرَى, and he puts forward the left to leave. وَإِذَا انْتَعَلَ فَهُوَ مِرْفَقٌ لِلْقَدَمِ, and when it comes to putting on a shoe, the shoe is a convenience for the foot, mirfaq. So mirfaq means convenience, advantage, and also the marafiq, you know, the elbows. So it has several meanings. And it is a Quranic word as well. تَقَدَّبَ الْيُمْنَى فِي الْمِرْفَقِ, and so he puts the right side first, he gives it priority in that convenience. And in the Quran, وَيُهَيِّئْ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَمْرِكُمْ مِرْفَقًا, and Allah shall arrange for you of all of your matters in life, advantages and conveniences and blessings. So all of that is part of that term. And even for lesser meanings, such as the privy, the latrine, we call that marafiq in modern Arabic, because they are one of the great conveniences of life. وَإِذَا نَزَعَ قَدَّمَ الْيُسْرَ, and whenever removing the shoe, he gives priority to the left. لِيَكُونَ ذَلِكَ الْمِرْفَقُ بَاقِيًا عَلَى الْيُمْنَى وَإِنْ قَلَّتِ الْمُدَّةِ, so that that convenience will remain for the right more, even for the shortest moment of time. وَكَانَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَسْتَعْمِلُ تَدْبِيرَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى وَيَتَفَقَّدُهُ, and the messenger of Allah, upon him blessings and peace of Allah, would always use the disposal or arrangement or order of Allah Most High and look for that, search it out. فَرُوِيَ عَنْهُ أَنَّهُ كَانَ يُحِبُّ التَّيَمُّنَ فِي كُلِّ شَيْءٍ حَتَّى فِي تَرَجُّلِهِ وَتَنَعُلِهِ وَطُهُورِهِ, and it is narrated that he loved starting with the right in everything, even in grooming his hair, in wearing his shoes, and in purifying himself. قال حدثنا بذلك محمد بن بشار, and he narrates with his chain, عن عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها, عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, and again another chain from عائشة also, عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, أنه كان يتيمن ما استطاع في طهوره إذا تطهر. So he used to start with the right to the extent that he could. See, and this is an important phrase which we did not see before in the literal wording of the hadith. So people who are left-handed should take that to heart, you see, to the extent that you can, and that's it. You are off the hook. And the rest is just an affair of your knowledge, your memory, your intention. When you make that intention, you get all the reward, just as if you were right-handed, and there is no difference between you and the right-handed person in that respect. You see, the respect of niyyah. It is all about niyyah. Because and if, even if one is right-handed but without the niyyah, then they will not get that credit, because their intention is not involved, and so it becomes a question of simple habit, and one is not rewarded for that. So here he the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam searching out how to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in even that small respect of starting with the right,
because subhanallah.
Allah made it the beginning and the priority and the choice. And so even in such a small matter, you accumulate rewards and blessings, protection, and light, inshallah. So he would start whenever he could with the right, in his purification, whenever he purified himself, وَفِي لِبَاسِهِ إِذَا لَبِسَ, and in his wearing clothes whenever he got dressed, وَفِي تَرَجُّلِهِ إِذَا تَرَجَّلَ, and in his grooming his hair, whenever he groomed his hair, which was not often, but they observed that. And وَفِي تَنَعُّلِهِ إِذَا تَنَعَّلَ, and in wearing his shoes whenever he shod himself. Now, why we say تَرَجُّل for grooming the hair? Because تَرَجَّلَ, coming from رِجِل, the foot, use tarajjala to, for example, someone coming down a well, feet first, you know, tarajjala. But you also, or use it for someone walking, right? So, tarajjala, and that cognate is also a Quranic word for infantry, people who are not mounted on horses or camels when going on a campaign. So why? Because it is also used for making yourself more like a man, you see. So grooming yourself, because someone who does not groom themselves, I mean face first, but also that includes the whole body, of course, not just the face and the hair, but also the whole body, washing and armpits and everything else, you see. Someone who does not take care of that, well, if they just neglect it long enough, they will look more and more like a bear in the woods, or you know, some very old you know, lion on the brink of death, who's who doesn't smell nice. So you take care of yourself, you groom yourself, become more like a man. Like, you know, the beautiful appearance of a man. Like Sayyida Aisha used to say, Subhanalladhi zayyana wujuh al-rijali bil-liha. Glory to the one that adorned the faces of men with beards. So you see, but taking care of it. So Imam Ahmad, mashallah, he has quite a few words on that. And they were compiled in this book by Abu Bakr al-Khalal called Tabu Tarajjul, the book of hair grooming. You see, or grooming oneself. Yes, it is a beautiful book. And it, of course, mentions, you know, hair and the fashions that the Sahaba followed, and parting the hair and or shaving, which is makruh, the hair, unless, of course, for a religious reason, such as Hajj and Tahleel in Umrah and so forth. And, you know, paring or clipping a little bit of the eyebrows when they get too long and they start to cover the eyes. Well, Imam Ahmad used to clip a little bit with scissors of that and so forth. the mustache, the beard, dyeing with coloring, and the armpits, and the rest of the body, including secondary matters, such as, you know, grooming, even the pubes, but also about circumcision, there is a section on that and so forth, which is all part of the hygiene inherited from the holy prophets upon them, blessings and peace.
So who is the writer, Sidi?
The writer is Al-Khalal. You know Al-Khalal, the student, students of Imam Ahmad. He's a student of the students of Imam Ahmad. So Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal is his grand sheikh. And Abu Bakr al-Khalal has the credit of gathering a lot of the fiqh of Imam Ahmad. And this is part of his great collection, encyclopedia of the fiqh of Imam Ahmad. But this is just an excerpt on that particular topic called Kitab al-Tarajjul. So this is the tarajjul that is meant here. Then he said, وَحَدَّثَنَا صَالِحُ بْنُ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ قال حدثنا أبو الأحوص with his chain to عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها. We mentioned that one. Another hadith, the next one is
Allah
from Anas رضي الله عنه that the Holy Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم لما رمى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الجمرة when he stoned, after he stoned the stoning pillar in Hajj, وَنَحَرَ نُسُكَهُ, and he slaughtered his sacrificial animal, the sacrificial offering, نَاوَلَ رَأْسَهُ الْحَلَّاقِ, he would then go over to the barber and tell him to shave his head. فقال, and he said, إِبْدَأْ بِالشِّقِّ الْأَيْمَنِ, start with the right side. This is something that I always forget to tell. And then when it's too late, I just don't insist. The barber, start with the right side. Do it, you will get ajr for the sunnah. فَحَلَقَهُ فَنَاوَلَهُ, and then he shaved it. And then he gave it Abu Talha. فَنَاوَلَهُ Abu Talha. He gave it to Abu Talha. ثُمَّ نَاوَلَهُ الْأَيْسَرَ فَحَلَقَهُ. So, you see, he gave him the hair from the right side of the head of the Prophet ﷺ, and the Prophet ﷺ gave that hair to Abu Talha. That is a huge gift. You see the blessings coming to the Sahaba al-Kiram who are waiting for that, and they are asking for that. Probably Abu Talha said his request in advance. ثُمَّ نَوَلَهُ الْأَيْسَرَ, then he gave the left side of his head to the barber, فَحَلَقَهُ, who shaved it, فَقَالَ اِقْسِمْهُ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ, that side, even just share it between the people. You see the difference in treatment? He gave the special side to even the hair of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So it's like Nur ala Nur, the right side, Nur ala Nur. حَدَّثَنَا قُتَيْبَةُ عَنْ مَالِكِ بْنِ أَنَسَ عَنْ إِبْنِ شِهَابٍ عَنْ أَنَسِ بْنِ مَالِكٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ أَنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أُتِيَ بِلَبَنٍ قَدْ شِيبَ بِمَا, the Holy Prophet ﷺ was brought some milk that had been diluted with water. So, you know, fresh, cool milk diluted with water is nothing better. It's like a meal. The Holy Prophet ﷺ literally called the milk a meal. So, therefore, you can, you know, dilute it a little bit. It will make more to share around. So it's mixed with water. So many things that, in fact, the ancients in ancient times did not drink, whole, because they diluted it to make it more. Now, I'm including milk. وَعَنْ يَمِينِهِ أَعْرَابِيٌّ, and to his right was a pure-blooded Arab. Or you can see a Bedouin Arab also for Arabi. وَعَنْ يَسَارِهِ أَبُو بَكْرٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَ عَنْهُ, and to his left, Abu Bakr, al-Siddiq. Again, you see, فَشَرِبَ, so the Holy Prophet ﷺ drank, ثُمَّ أَعْطَى الْأَعْرَابِيَّ, and then he gave it to the Bedouin. فَقَالَ الْأَيْمَنَ فَالْأَيْمَنَ, first the right and then the right. to the right of the right. So before, you see, he asked permission from his cousin, because his cousin, his blood, his household, is so close to him, see? And so it is fine. But with someone that is not so close, so he did not want to, he was shy to ask him maybe, or out of munificence, and he disregarded that his preference would have been to give it to Abu Bakr. But then he followed the sunnah, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him that sunnah, and he loved to follow that most. And then he narrated through Imam Malik, but from a different sahabi, Sahal ibn Sa'd al-Sa'idi radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, the same, or something near it, عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بنحوه. قال حدثنا قتيبة عن مالك عن ابن شهاب عن أبي بكر بن عبد الله عن ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال. Now a tawsiya of the Holy Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, إذا أكل أحدكم فليأكل بيمينه وإذا شرب أحدكم فليشرب بيمينه. Whenever one of you eats, let him eat with his right. And whenever one of you drinks, let him drink with his right. We see, even if our hand is greasy from food, and we take the cup with the non-greasy hand for the convenience of others, or if we're not going to share it, even to keep the cup, not to make it dirty, still you touch it with the right to that intention, you see, to that intention. So it is the easiest thing also for a right-handed person. Physically, they know that they can do all those things with the left, you see, eating and drinking. So perhaps for the left-handed person also, they can do those things with the right easily, and inshallah, they can add to their intention the follow-up of actually doing it, because then in that case, istata, there is istita, there is ability to do it with the right. So we do it with the right. But that does that mean that it is you know, taboo to use the left under any circumstance? No, it's not, as we just showed, you see. But stronger than this example that I mentioned about the greasy hand and the cup, stronger than that, much stronger than that, there is the example of the Holy Prophet ﷺ when eating dates together with watermelon, and he would have the date in his right hand and the watermelon in the left, and he did that to show that it was fine if your right hand is busy and use the left. And he was holding the two together to say, and this is a hadith, نَكْسِرُ حَرَّ هَذِهِ بِبَرْدِ هَذِهِ or كَمَقَال أو كَمَقَال. يعني we break the hotness of this one, because the date is a hot food, with the coolness of that one, or this one, the watermelon being a cool food. And among the coolest of foods also is the cucumber. This is why the Arabs would say, a cucumber you can eat before food, during food, and after food, because it is like drinking water. So this is to show that if the right hand is busy, it is fine to eat with the left. And if a person is unable to use their right hand, either because it is paralyzed or missing, then using the left is 100% fine as well, you see. But I'm talking now about the people who can use both. قال أبو عبد الله, so Imam Hakim al-Tirmidhi said, وَإِنَّمَا ذَكَرَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ مِنْ شَأْنِ الْيَمِينِ مَا أَعْلَمَ الْعِبَادَ مُخْتَارَهُ وَفَضِيلَتَهُ. And so the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the right side, that by which he informed the servants of his choice and his bounty. So he associated his choice and his bounty, his preference, and his reward to the right side. So this is what we are pursuing and reminding ourselves of whenever we associate our niyya to the act of putting the right side first. And then the next hadith, عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال. And look how much Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala emphasized that, because he associated it to himself, and he is now speaking of his own right hand. قال يمين الله ملأ سحاء. The right hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the right side of Allah, the right of Allah, يمين الله, is full.
يمين الله.
Is full and always outpouring. سحاء. So saha is something with downpouring of bounty that never stops, permanently pouring. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always giving. لا يغيضها شيء بالليل والنهار. Nothing of the night and the day diminishes it in the least. Nothing of the night and the day, Allahu Akbar. That means, as we often heard Mawlana Sheikh Hisham in his dua saying, Allahumma ahsin ilayna bi ihsanika al-qadim. Oh Allah, grant us your super excellence. Grant us your abundant goodness now, as you always did before, even before time. Even before time. Yani, ihsanika al-qadim, al-qadim, when it applies to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this being one of his attributes as narrated in the Sunan, among the asma al-husna, al-qadim. And ihsanika al-qadim, your abundant generosity that has no beginning, that is so. In other words, whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave of goodness before, it is still continuing. It is still continuing, but Allah is saying in another hadith, who is asking? In the Hadith Qudsi, who is asking so that I may give? But Allah's generosity and abundance never stops. Nothing diminishes it, you see, of all the centuries and millennia passing, on millions of years of creation passing, nothing diminishes it. And it is always pouring. And this is what al-layl wa nahar, not whether night or day, yani the passing of time, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created time. So, and then finally, another hadith, and then I will pause again. عن عمر بن الخطاب سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول. I heard the messenger of Allah, upon him the blessings and peace of Allah, say, إن الله تعالى خلق آدم. Verily, Allah, the exalted, created Adam, upon him peace. فمسح ظهره بيمينه. And he wiped his back with his right hand. فاستخرج منه ذرية. And he brought out from him a progeny, a seed. فقال خلقت هؤلاء للجنة. And we know from another hadith that he brought them out to be seen physically in the form of ants, an unlimited number of ants. And he said, I created these ones for paradise. وَبِعَمَلِ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ يَعْمَلُونَ. And they practice the deeds of the people of paradise. May Allah make us of them. Ameen. ثُمَّ مَسَحَ ظَهْرَهُ بِيَسَارِهِ. Then he wiped down his back with his left hand. فَاسْتَخْرَجَ مِنْهُ ذُرِّيَّةً. And he brought out from him a progeny. فقال خلقت هؤلاء للنار وبعمل أهل النار يعملون اللهم لا تجعلنا منهم. I created these ones for hellfire, and they practice the deeds of the people of hellfire. May Allah not make us of them. Ameen. So this hadith is strongly authentic. It is narrated by Imam Malik in his Muwatta, and it is narrated in the Sunan as well, such as the Sunan of Abu Dawood and An-Nasa'i in Al-Kubra and others, including Ibn Hibban in his Sahih. So I mention this because it contains the extraordinary, or not, it's out of the ordinary to mention also the left hand verbatim like that, biyasarihi. But we will see something that tempers that following up, inshallah. Then another hadith from Abu Umama, an Abi Umama radiallahu anhu, qala qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, khalaqa Allahu al-khalqa wa qada al-qadiyya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created creation and closed the case, ended the matter. Meaning, qada and qadar. Wa arshuhu ala al-ma', when his throne was over the water. And this is a huge expression, of course. We know it from Surah Hud. Wa kana arshuhu ala al-ma'. So we go to the tafsirs of that. And inshallah, for the correct interpretation, yani, it shows the importance of the throne, of course, and the primacy of its creation. And then, of course, water also, out of which was created life, also has primacy in creation. فَأَخَذَ أَهْلَ الْيَمِينِ بِالْيَمِينِ. So he took the people of the right side with the right hand. وَأَخَذَ أَهْلَ الشِّمَالِ بِالشِّمَالِ. And he took the people of the left side with the left hand. You see another example, like the hadith we read before, showing the mention of left hand in relation to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the hadith that I was thinking about when I said there is something that qualifies all that, also from Abu Umamata radiallahu ta'ala anhu, عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, خلق الله الخلق وقضى القضية, same as before. وأخذ ميثاق النبيين, and he took the covenant of prophets. وعرشه على الماء, when his throne was over the water. فأخذ أهل اليمين بيمينه وأخذ أهل الشمال بالأخرى. So here there is a slight difference in wording. And he took the people of the right side with her right hand, and he took the people of the left side with the other. You see? So there is a kind of calculated avoidance of mentioning left. And in order to underline that avoidance, the Holy Prophet ﷺ said, وَكِلْتَ يَدَيِ الرَّحْمَنِ يَمِينَ. And both of the hands of the All-Merciful are rights. Rights. Yani, right hand. Yes. So to say that, as we say, Allahumma al-khayru kulluhu minka wa ilayk. Yani, goodness is all from you and back to you. Yani, any side, when we speak of, from any aspect of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is all goodness, you see. Even the decree of khayri wa sharri min Allah ta'ala, so it is still all goodness, you see. That is the position of the believer. So there is a maqam of tawheed here, of pure tawheed and recognition of the pure monotheism of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his absoluteness in goodness, which this phrase underlines, you see. And it's a phrase out of this world, because don't look for any resemblance in this world or even in language. Just, you know, you can't figure it out. So just, you know, accept it and let it pass, that both his hands, the hands of the All-Merciful, are rights. ثُمَّ, or are right hands. ثُمَّ قَالَ يَا أَصْحَابَ الْيَمِينَ. Then he said, oh, people of the right. قَالُوا لَبَّيْكَ رَبَّنَا وَسَعْدَيْكَ. He said, oh, our nurturing Lord, at your service and at your good pleasure, twice. So لَبَّيْكَ, يعني, is, there is a dual here, and سَعْدَيْكَ, twice, you see. قَالَ أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ. He said, am I not your nurturing Lord? قَالُوا بَلَى. He said, of course, yes. Nay, yes, indeed, yes, بَلَى. أَقَالْ يَا أَصْحَابَ الشِّمَالِ. Oh, people of the left. قَالُوا لَبَّيْكَ وَسَعْدَيْكَ. قَالَ أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ. قَالُوا بَلَى. Again, the same question and the same answer. فَخَلَطَ بَعْضَهُمْ بِبَعْضٍ. And then he mixed them all up. We are talking about the beginning of creation here. Mixed them all up. فَخَلَطَ بَعْضَهُمْ بِبَعْضٍ.
Allah, Allah.
Together. Allahu Akbar. وَقَالْ وله نعم فقال قائل منهم and one of them said ربي. This is our voice through them speaking, because we want to ask that question as well. And look, Allah made one of them ask it. لِمَا خَلَقْتَ بَيْنَنَا? Why did you mix us all up? See, why are we mixed up here in this world with everyone else? We don't know which side we are on. We don't know. We cannot tell. Anyone that claims that they know, then they can only say what Allah and His Prophet ﷺ said. If they know that and they adhere to that, then Allah knows best as to the truth of their words. And may our words, if we say that, be truthful. Ameen. He said, he replied, وَلَهُمْ أَعْمَالٌ مِنْ دُونِ ذَلِكَ هُمْ لَهَا عَامِلُونَ. So this is a verse from Surah Al-Mu'minun. The whole verse says, بَلْ قُلُوبُهُمْ فِي غَمْرَةٍ مِنْ هَذَا. But their hearts are in indifference or in ignorance, deep ignorance of this. And this matter, the purpose of creation, the wisdom of the tests. وَلَهُمْ أَعْمَالٌ مِنْ دُونِ ذَلِكَ. And they have deeds that are below par, below the good deeds. هُمْ لَهَا عَامِلُونَ. Which they are committing. Now, فَقَالَ قَائِلٌ مِّنْهُمْ فَمَا الْأَعْمَالُ. So one of them said, what are the deeds? قَالْ يَعْمَلُ كُلُّ قَوْمٍ لِمَنْزِلَتِهِمْ. Every people do deeds according to their level, according to their residence. So what residence is that? Residence in Akhirah, level in Akhirah. See, the level that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided, then according to that level, look at the deeds that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is inspiring us and leading us on to do in life. That is an announcement of the hereafter. May Allah make them good. Ameen. From beginning to end. Ameen. فَقَالَ عُمَرُ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ إِذَنْ نَجْتَهِدْ. Therefore, we do our best. We strive. We do jihad of nafs. And we do our best to do our best. Why? Because we do not know. No one knows until after this life. At the time of death, then Allah will remove that cover. And فَبَصَرُكَ الْيَوْمَ حَدِيدٌ. At that time, your sight, your eyesight will be extremely sharp. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us see only good. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من عذاب القبر ومن عذاب النار ومن الفتن ما تقدم منها وما تأخر ومن فتنة المسيح الدجال ومن فتنة المحيا والممات. We seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of the tests and the trials of this life and of death. Ameen. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار.
آمين.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد السيد الأبرار. اللهم صل على سيدنا
آمين.
سيد الأخيار.
آمين.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد نور الأنوار. اللهم صل
آمين.
على سيدنا محمد سر الأسرار. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد ترياق الأغيار. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين. ما
آمين.
أظلم ليل وما أشرق نهار إلى يوم الدين. وبارك وسلم
آمين.
كثيرا. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام
على المرسلين. آمين.
الحمد لله رب العالمين. الفاتحة.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم. مالك يوم الدين. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. صراط المستقيم.
Thank you for joining.
آمين.
Bless you. Bless us. آمين. دنيا وآخرة. And we'll see you next time.
الله. آمين. آمين.
ورحمة الله.
آمين. إن شاء الله. آمين. وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله.